Hello, baseball fans, and welcome. MLB The Show has interleague action for you this afternoon. It's the Pittsburgh Pirates taking on the Seattle Mariners. First pitch coming your way next. So just about set at the plate for Pittsburgh, Key Brian Hayes. The big lefty turns, kicks, deals. That one misses, and that's how this game gets started. And now the lefty. So two balls and no strikes.
Well, he's so great about hitting the ball the other way. He gets those arms extended. So right there, just trying to straighten him up a little bit so he doesn't have as much outside plate coverage.
In for a strike, now 3-1.
I got 3-1. Three balls, one strike.
The pitch. Swings and misses. And a full count now. The wind of the pitch. It's a leadoff walk, and that's the go-ahead run.
Well, a breaking ball in that 3-2 count kind of tells you that that's the pitch he has the most confidence in right now. Just couldn't find the strike zone.
And now, Yoshi Tsutsugo. Hayes aboard here at first with nobody out. Next pitch is outside.
No, he's really working him away this at bat. Sometimes take a little bit off velocity. Try to get a rollover, something on the ground. Stay away from that big hole on the right side of the infield.
And that one wrapped foul. Left-hand batter waits. Strike two.
With two strikes, may see some movement over there at first base, trying to stay out of a double play here.
Checks over to first, back safely. Runner at first with no outs here. Got him swinging. One down. Brian Reynolds here.
The center fielder, number 10, Brian Reynolds.
And the first pitch misses for ball one. At the belt and fires. There's a strike.
If he doesn't get a knock right here, that pitch he just took is going to eat at him for a while. You might not see another pitch like that.
Runner on the go. Pitch misses. Throw to second. Tag out at second. Oh, now this is blasted way back there on its way. Gone. Brian Reynolds leaves the yard, and that gives him a lead. It's 1-0. Here's Daniel Vogelback. Next offering is down low, and that's ball one. Fouled off to the right. Ball to strike. And strike two.
One ball, two strikes.
The 1-2. And delivers outside. Left-hand hitter waits. Just misses the mark outside the zone.
No, he's not afraid to fall into a two-strike count. Knows the strike zone there.
Swing and a miss. And he's down on strikes. And that will end the inning. Bottom of the first. Here's the veteran second baseman, Adam Frazier. And here it comes. Good eye right there. Righty delivers. That one down the line. That's a fair ball, and it's getting into the corner. Could be extra bases. Safe at second with nobody out, and he represents the tying.
But turning on that pitch and smoking it down the line, and there's no one playing there, so once it drops in fair, you're on your way to extra bases.
And now, Ty France. First pitch doesn't find the zone. Righty to the plate. Missing inside. And the count is 2-0. So the tying run at second. And it is 2-1.
This is one of those situations where the pitcher may not really want to deal with the guy in the box. And you got to be aware of that. Take your walk.
He swings and drives one out to deep left field. And out of here. Ty France goes deep. And the Mariners have the lead. It's 2-1. Here's Jesse Winker. He's someone that really beats up on right-handed pitching. The lefties, however, give him a little bit more trouble. First pitch, and he just misses.
Part of the order coming through now, and with one home run already in this inning, they're definitely looking to do some more damage.
Here's a 1-1. Swing and a miss.
Well, he's realizing out there on the mound that he's got to settle in pretty quickly, or else he's going to get hit hard in this first inning.
And there's a fly ball deep right field. That's what the fans came to see, and they add to the lead. It's 3-1. Now batting Mitch Haniger. And he swings and misses at the initial offering. The pitch. And a foul ball. He stays alive.
Clearly trying to stay back a little bit longer for that changeup as he fouls that fastball back.
Next one just misses. And a count 1-2. Stays alive. Ground ball to Tsugo. Oh, the throw is wild. Eugenio Suarez up to the plate now. And Chris, probably no other player better represents present-day baseball than this guy. A lot of power, a lot of strikeouts, and some walks. And that's in there for strike one.
Really important for the pitcher to not get proud, stay with the scouting report, and don't throw something into his swing.
He's kind of channeling Adam Dunn. Man at second. And 1-2. The 1-2. Got him. And there's one down. J.P. Crawford gets a chance to hit. J.P. Crawford. First offering, and it just misses.
Well, with this many pitches thrown here in this first inning, I mean, you're giving the other team a really good look. He's going to have to find a way to get some weak contact, maybe a swing and miss, get into that dugout, and hit the reset button.
And he's out. And stepping in for the Mariners, Julio Rodriguez. First offering misses the mark.
He's been trying to tease the zone with that slider, but these hitters have showed patience, not going outside the strike zone.
Swung on, belted. That's back there. Gone. So he blasts one out the other way, and they tack on to their lead. It's 5-1. Two outs, nobody on. Here's Jerry Kelnick. And he swings and misses, and it's nothing and one.
Well, it's not the inning he was planning on to begin this start, but you've got to find a way to shake things off and give your team some length and put up some zeros.
Next pitch misses, and it's 2-1.
That's where you want it. It's a good miss.
Two outs. There's a strike. And that's downstairs and outside.
Recognize that changeup right out of the hand. Just spit on it.
Fouled off again. And it remains 3-2. Payoff pitch. And there's ball four.
One of the things about that two-out walk, the base runner over at first base is going to have a very aggressive secondary lead. So a ball down the line or into the gap will produce a two-out RBI, and those are the best. That is if you are the offensive side of it.
Tom Murphy stands in now and lets that one go for a strike. Next offering is in for a strike.
Very well executed changeup right there. If he can command the fastball consistently, that's going to be an important pitch in terms of him turning this outing around.
Next offering is foul back. Pitch misses there, and the count is 1-2. Swings through that, and it's a strikeout. That's the third out. Top of the second at the plate for Pittsburgh, Anthony Alford.
Leading off for Pittsburgh, the left fielder, Anthony.
Here comes a pitch. And there's the strike. A little out front there as he swings through it.
Man, he really sells the changeup with that arm action.
Kicks and fires. Pitch misses, and it's 1-2.
I got the count, 1-2.
And a foul ball, he stays alive. The wide to kick the pitch. Next offering misses down and away. And down on strikes. One out in second. Here's Ben Gamble. And the first pitch misses for ball one. One down, base is empty. In there at the knees, and the count 1-1. The pitch. Popped in the air, left field. Kelman puts it away, two down. Two outs, base is empty. Roberto Perez standing in. Roberto. And first offering is fouled off. The pitch.
Inside, ball one.
That's inside, two and one.
Boog, he never moved because he never had time to. But that kind of velocity, you'd prefer that pitcher work away.
Next pitch, not close, up high. And he deals. Now a blast to left center, way back there, on its way, out of here. Roberto Perez leaves the yard, and they're chipping away. It's 5-2. Next to hit, Cole Tucker, a switch hitter batting right. Swings through that one, 0-1. And the pitch. Late that time, and it's strike two.
Spin rate's outstanding on that high fastball. Really tough to hit.
Next offering is down low. And the pitch. And a swing and a miss. And that's that. Bottom half of inning number two. Here's the Mariners leadoff man, Adam Frazier.
Second baseman, Adam Frazier.
The pitch. Now a screamer into the outfield. He's got it, and there's one away. And the batter now, Ty France. He's already homered in this one. In there, and it's 0-1.
Well, he left that changeup up, got away with one there, and he'll take it, but doesn't want to make that mistake again.
Next offering is in for a strike. And the righty deals. Swing and a miss. The velocity blasted it right past him. And the batter now, Jesse Winker. One for one so far today with a solo homer in his first at bat. Smash to the left side. Hayes to first. Three up, three down, inning over. Top half of the third inning, and now the shortstop, Kevin Newman.
Leading off for the Pirates, the shortstop, Kevin.
And a pitch. Ball one there. That's in for a strike. Kicks and deals. Check swing. He went. One and two. And now the lefty. Foul ball there. And a pitch.
Two balls, two strikes.
Cut on and miss. Struck him out. And one away. Now batting key Brian Hayes. And when you talk about elite defensive third baseman, this guy is at the top of the list. In the air, right field, Haniger settles underneath it, and there's two down. Two outs, bases empty. So next to the plate for Pittsburgh, Yoshi Tsutsugo. He was a strikeout victim his first time. Pitch misses inside, ball one. The big lefty turns, kicks, deals. And a foul ball makes the count 2-1. Next pitch is popped up. Suarez under it. Drops into the glove. And that's the third out. As we go to the last of the third. And now it's the cleanup hitter for the Mariners, Mitch Haniger.
Haniger.
The pitch. And a breaking ball drops in for a strike.
Well, he's back out here for the third, and after the first couple of innings, pretty rough. I think the skipper's looking for him to give him a little bit of length, see if he can save the bullpen some.
Next offering is in for a strike. Swings and misses. One out. Hey, Eugenio Suarez up to hit down. His first at bat was a strikeout. That hits the dirt, and it's 1-0. At the belt and fires. Just off the outside edge. And that one is in for a strike. Got him. That's his second strikeout. Now it's going to be J.P. Crawford.
Shortstop, J.P.
that's important. If he can go 1-2-3 here, will be a very positive sign for him and for his team.
Broken bat, and it's popped up. Pulls it down, and he makes the catch. And that'll do it. Out of the fourth, at the plate for Pittsburgh, Brian Reynolds.
Leading off for the Pirates, the center fielder, number 10, Brian.
The pitch. Fastball in for a strike. It's 0-1. That one lifted to left. Kelnick in position. Makes the grab, one down.
Just pulled off of it a little bit right there. That front shoulder coming open instead of staying closed. If he does that, he's going to be able to go up the middle the other way with some authority instead of a fly out to left.
Vogelback in now. Takes ball one off the plate. The 1-0. And he pumps it a strike. Chris, we were excited to watch him pitch. This is a little more along the lines of what we were expecting performance-wise.
Yeah, but great pitchers like this, you may get one opportunity in one inning to get to them, to get some runs up on the board. And if you don't take it then, you may see zeros the rest of the ballgame.
3-1, and he couldn't come up with it. How big a deal is that walk?
I don't think it's a big deal, because if you pitch to the previous hitter with the power he has, he can hit a home run. I think it was a calculated walk. We'll see how it pays off here.
Alford stands in now, looks at that one inside.
Maybe losing command a little bit after the walk. Next pitch, not even close.
And he deals. Late on that fastball.
Now this guy's definitely looking for a big swing of the bat right here. Try to close that gap. But, you know, at the very least, if you can find a way to manufacture that run from first, it feels like it's really important to getting back into this ballgame.
The pitch. That one fouled off. 2-2. On the ground to the left. And it goes just foul. Kicks and fires. Stays alive. Is there a little wrinkle to that? I think there was.
Yeah. Little slider action.
And the pitch. The punch out there. And he's down on strikes for the second time today. Ben Gamel, the next Pirate to hit. Flied out his first time. In there for strike one. Two outs.
1-1.
Vogelback leads off first with two down to the inning. Pitch misses. Ball two. And here it comes. The 2-1 is high. Left-hand batter waits.
Okay.
Check swing, but he went too far. And it's 3-2. And a swing and a miss. Down on strikes. And that is that. Ready to go for the last half of the inning. And now the center fielder, Julio Rodriguez.
The center fielder, Julio Rodriguez.
Keller back to work. They say he went.
Hold on to the count.
Righty to the plate. And a pop up, right side, foul territory. And there's one down. And up next for Seattle, Jared Kelnick. And the first offering is not close. And the right-hander deals. And that one fouled off. The pitch. And that's outside. Right-hander kicks, deals. Inside, just missed. Here comes a pitch. And he walked him.
Nope. Looked like a questionable call in that spot. He even seemed a little surprised it went his way at the plate. But as a hitter, you'll take that all day.
Now it's Tom Murphy. Way inside, and that hit him.
Well, anytime one of your guys gets drilled, it catches everyone's attention in the dugout. And you know what? It kind of gets you fired up.
Here's Adam Frazier. First offering misses badly for ball one. Swings and lines a base hit into left field. And they stop him at third, so base is loaded with one away.
Just a cookie down the middle. I mean, those are the ones you dream about. The ones in the cage, you're just hoping you get in the ball game. Right down the middle, not a whole lot of velocity, right on top of it. Now the base is loaded. Big opportunity for them to break this game open.
On the mound now, Anthony Banda. The bases are loaded, so no time to settle into this one.
Well, at this point of the ball game, we're talking about middle innings, and you need a little length out of this arm coming out of the bullpen. We'll see just how many outs he's able to give his skipper.
And here is Ty France. One out, bases full. Ground ball left side, could be two. To second for one. And that's quick work out of the pen. One batter, two outs, inning over. We go to the top of the fifth, and now the catcher comes up to hit. Roberto Perez. The why to kick the pitch. And that skips in the dirt. And that one a little bit high.
Two balls, no strike.
And now 2-1.
Well, he came right at him right there, challenged him with the 2-0 fastball. Not sure exactly what he was looking for, but got to imagine that's a confidence booster on the mound. You're in that hitter's head a little bit.
The next pitch misses. Counts full, 3-2. Good plate appearance there. Able to take the walk.
Well, he's starting to look a little gassed to me, and we'll see if they go to the bullpen in this spot or not.
Cole Tucker will hit next. First pitch doesn't find the zone.
Well, the leadoff man gets on. You want to minimize the threat by playing sound defense. Hopefully the pitcher can get a ball on the ground and they can roll him up for two.
Swings and misses, and a count 1-1. The pitch. Line drive, and that's a base hit out into center field. Just kind of sliced that one into center. The batter now, Kevin Newman. Went down on strikes his first time through. In the dirt. But no advance from the runners. And now the lefty. Swing and a ball popped up. That gets down for a hit. And they're happy to play station to station right here. Bases loaded. Nobody out. And here is Key Brian Hayes. That one's in there, 0-1. On the ground, two ball. Over to Frazier. On to first, but he beats it. And a run scores. Up next for the Pirates, Yoshi Tsutsugo.
He's looking for a ground ball to get a double play and out of this jam.
Next pitch downstairs. Ball one.
Ball one, no strike.
Two on, one out. And a foul ball.
I think ultimately you want to tie him up, get the ball in on the plate so that he can't get the barrel to it and hit it to the outfield.
Next one misses, two and one.
Good spot for the hitter. Definitely has the advantage in this count with runners on. Look for him to be aggressive on this next pitch.
Swings and misses. And the count is even, two and two. Lefty out of the stretch. Runners at first and third. Got him. Huge strikeout there. Brian Reynolds digs in now. Good contact guy, good defender. First offering misses the mark. And that's through there for a strike. Corners are occupied with two down. Slow roller to first. He'll do it himself. That ends the frame. It ain't no surprise. Back at T-Mobile Park, we head to the bottom of the fifth. Now it's the Mariners DH, Jesse Winker. The wind of the pitch.
Winker.
Strike one. In the dirt, one and two to count. That one missed. 2-2 down. Now a pop-up on the infield. Tutugo gets under it. Makes the grab, one away.
That was a good pitch to hit right down the heart of the plate. Had pretty good timing on it. Just got underneath it a little bit and popped it up.
Haniger batting with one down. Takes the strike. Next offering misses, and now it's even, one and one. Kicks and deals. And that one just missed off the outside edge.
Now you get to this part of the order, yeah, there's some pop there, but more likely there's some base hits. So very important to be patient. Let the pitcher walk you, if he will.
Hard hit left side, and it finds its way through for a hit. So they get a man aboard with a one-out single.
Well, patience and discipline paid off right there as he got into an advantage count. There was nothing cheap about the way he got that one through the infield. That was ripped, caught out in front, and didn't get under it like he would have liked, but definitely put a good swing on it.
Suarez up to the plate for the third time as he looks at one down low. The lefty, the 1-0. This one in the dirt. Low throw, and he can't dig it out. Runner leads away at second.
Ball. I got 3-1. Three balls, one strike.
And a foul ball. And a pitch. And ball four, two aboard.
Almost a coin flip for the umpire in that call, but most umpires just don't want to give pitchers a break up in the zone like that.
And now for Seattle, J.P. Crawford. Pitch misses inside, and that is ball one. at the belt and fires. That one called a strike, and a count 1-1. That clips the corner.
He's been able to go inside as well as outside, effectively working both sides of the plate in this at bat.
And a pitch. The other way. Alford racing over to make the catch. And stepping in for the Mariners, Julio Rodriguez.
Looking for some insurance. Or as our friends down in the South would say,
insurance.
No matter how you say it, we know what you mean.
And that's in there for strike one.
Well, we call that keyholing. Even though it's right there and looks pretty good, if he doesn't love it, he's not going to swing that early in the count.
And he's down 0-2 as he swings through it. And a pitch. Towards first. He handles it himself. And the inning is over. We're back, and they make a change to start the sixth. The new pitcher, Diego Castillo. And he'll work on holding this lead. All right, we go to the top half of inning number six. Now at the plate, Daniel Vogelbach. The wind of the pitch. Bounding ball here, rolls foul. The wind of the pitch. And that one almost got him. Next offering is in for a strike. Right-handed reliever. And fouled off. Vogelbach stays alive. And the righty deals. Takes it in for the out. Stepping in, Anthony Alford.
Left fielder, Anthony Alford.
In there, and it's 0-1. And ball one. Here's a 1-1. That's down and in. The pitch. And that gets the inside corner for a strike. The pitch. Swing and a miss, and he is down on strikes for the third straight at bat. Two outs, base is empty. So next to the plate for Pittsburgh, Ben Gamel. And he swings and misses at the initial offering. Two down, nobody on. And now it's even up.
You want to be patient here. Try to work a walk if you can. You've got a big power bat behind you in the on-deck circle. And with two outs, one swing can put you right back in this ballgame.
And look out as that one ran in and got him. He had him 1-2, and he ends up hitting him with a pitch.
Well, it's safe to say he won't be getting invited to the charity golf tournament this offseason.
Roberto Perez stands in with two away as he takes a ball. And the 1-0. Swing and a miss, strike one. Kicks and fires. So a foul ball makes it 1-2.
Threw open a little bit with that front shoulder, but was able to slow his bat down just enough to make contact with that pitch, keep the at-bat alive.
Next offering way off the plate. Just misses with that one.
3-2, two out, runner on first. A lot of movement in the infield. Hitter's got to stay focused on the pitch.
The 3-2 is off the outside edge, and that is ball four.
Not what he wanted to do there, Boog. That keeps this inning alive and gives this offense a good chance to cut into their deficit.
New arm out of the bullpen, Drew Steckenrider, trying to protect this lead. At the plate for Pittsburgh, Cole Tucker. This is what stat nerds like myself might call a high leverage situation.
Yeah, Boog, not sure what the numbers say, but clearly an at bat that could change the course of this game dramatically.
And the first pitch misses for ball one. Two on, two outs. Fought off foul. Righty delivers. Swing and a miss. And it's one and two. And he deals. Swing and a chopper. Crawford picks it up. Got him on the off-balance throw. And that is the third out of the inning. And welcome back. Bottom of the sixth inning. And now for Seattle, Jared Kelnick. Fonda back to work.
Well, on paper, it's favorable to have a fairly quick inning here with two of the three hitters he's set to face batting from the left side, same side he throws from.
And here comes. Line drive. And he pulls up on it, and that's a hit.
Nice job of driving that pitch the other way on a line. You know, hitters, they take so many reps in the cages working on going to the opposite field, and it doesn't always translate into the game, but right there it did, and he did it perfectly.
So here's Murphy now. First pitch, just misses. And now the lefty. There's a strike. The pitch bounce to the right side and a base hit. Lead runner holds up. They're at first and second with nobody out.
That's back-to-back singles for them. Not much to this one other than just a willingness to go the other way and put the ball in play. That's a team to bat right there. Nice job of staying back and letting the ball get deep.
And that one fouled off. Kelnick, the lead runner at second. Murphy at first with no outs. Next pitch is outside.
And that's awfully close. I don't know how you take that. He's seeing the ball out of the pitcher's hand really well right now.
Here's a 1-2. Just missed.
Sometimes you got to fight to get back into an at-bat. Take some tough pitches, even out the count.
2-2 now. That one the other way. Hauls it in, and there's one away. Digging in, Ty France. He's already homered in this game. First pitch doesn't find the zone. Runners at first and second with one gone. Next pitch inside. Two balls, no strikes to count. On the inside corner for a strike.
I got 2-1 to count.
Next pitch misses, and that's ball three. Two on, one out. Now this is in the air down the line. Gamble has this one sized up, and there's two away. So first and second with two outs. Jesse Winker up next for the Mariners. Base hit. Kelnick around third. The tag, and that's out number three, inning over. New pitcher for the Mariners, Paul Sewald. And he'll do his best to hang on to this lead. Back in Seattle, all set for the start of the inning. At the plate for Pittsburgh, Kevin Newman. And the pitch. And that's outside. And there's the strike.
One ball, one strike.
Right-hander kicks, deals. And now one and two. The pitch. And a foul ball. He stays alive. And the right-hander deals. Stays alive. And a ball and two strikes. And fouled off. Next offering upstairs. The pitch. That one fouled off. Kicks and deals. And it's fouled away. Here comes a pitch. And now the count filled up 3-2.
This is a really good feeling for a hitter. At this point in the ball game, you know that they don't want to walk you, so you're going to get a pitch to hit. You just better not miss it.
The 3-2 is off the outside edge, and that is ball four.
Oh, looking for a swing and miss right there, or for the ump to help him out and make a call with that last pitch, but neither happened. Close pitch, but a good take to earn that walk.
Hayes can't hold up, and that's a strike. The tying run at the plate, and it's even up.
That two-seam fastball is usually coupled with a slider away, and when a hitter's conscious of the pitch in, it's hard for him to cover middle away, and that's where a pitcher can really finish off that batter.
Racing makes the catch, and there's one down.
Now, that's a tough play for the infielder ranging back into the outfield. There's part of him that's saying, hey, where you at, outfielder? Call me off. But he stayed focused and made a nice catch right there.
Tutugo stands in now and watches strike one. And there's a foul ball. Left-hand batter waits. Swings through that one. It's a strikeout. And there's two away. Up next for the Pirates, Brian Reynolds. 1-3. First offering, and it just misses. Newman off of first with two away. Next pitch is outside. And that one off the outside edge.
Big pitch coming right here. Last thing he wants to do is put the tying run on base, but he can't groove one either.
Two outs. In the air, left field. Kelmick drifts towards it. And that is the ball game.
Well, this was a tightly played game. Got a little of everything. Some timely hitting, runs on the board. Key pitching and defense in certain spots. Definitely a fun one to watch.
A 5-3 final score in this one. For Chris Singleton and our entire outstanding crew here at MLB The Show, I'm John Ciambi. We'll see you soon.
for the Pirates. Three runs, four hits, two errors. They left six men on base. Time of the ball game, 3 hours and 5 minutes. Thank you for joining us here this afternoon. And we remind you that we drive home safely.